Hey guys, today we're going to learn about SQLite. SQLite is an open source database that stores data to a file in your Android device. Android comes with SQLite built in. What I have here is a brand new application. It's just finished building. I've named it My Contacts. We're going to create a simple application that saves people's contacts on an SQLite database in their phone. So, the first thing we need to do is to create our model class. This is our contact class that will hold our data, our single instances of a contact. Like each contact will be held in this class. So what I already have is the class itself created. You simply click New Java Class. And you write the name and hit OK. Alright, so let's talk about what data a contact holds. The first one obviously is the name, and then of course you would have the phone number of the person, and you can hold also a bunch of other details about the person. You could have their email, their organization, etc., etc. So let's add a few. So name is obviously a string data type. Then we also have number, which some might think would be a numeric, but consider a number like 0708 or 09111222. If you were to save this as a number, the zero would disappear once you save it onto a database. And then also consider foreign numbers or numbers with country codes. So that would start with +254, for example, +254 followed by what have you. So this plus obviously cannot be stored with a numeric data type. So number falls under string as well. Then let's have organization. And finally, email. In fact, I will terminate then put email first. Yes, so name, number, email, and organization. That's what we want to store in each contact. Now, the next thing we need is an ID, and this will be an integer. So in the database, the ID will be the unique identifier for the contact. A contact can share a name, and perhaps for some reason could share a number, but no contact will share the same ID. All right, so that is it. That is all the details that we'll store about the contact. Now let's create a constructor. First we'll create an empty constructor. So for that one, I can just type it. But for the next one, I will hit Alt and Insert. And on the menu that shows up, I will click Constructor and select all of these. And when I hit OK, my constructor is automatically made. So this is a constructor with the integer. Now let's create one that has all these details, but without the integer. Oh, I shouldn't type that. So select just the name, the number, email, and organization. There we go. And finally, what we need is getters and setters. So once again, Alt Insert. Excuse me. Getter and setter. Hit Enter. Select all of these and press Enter. And they are there. All our getters and setters have been generated. So that's our class. It only will only be holding the name, the number, the email, and organization for now. We have our constructors and our getters and setters.